Hello, Sumac Voyagers. It's Principal Logan here. We have some very distinguished guests with us. None other than our wonderful and fantastic Las Virgenes Unified School District Director of Elementary Education, Miss Laura Kintz. Welcome, Miss Kintz.
Thank you, Principal Logan, and hello, everyone.
And we also have the one, the only, the fantastic office manager of Sumac Elementary, Mrs. Edna Sandoval. Good afternoon, Mrs. Sandoval.
Hola, buenas tardes.
Y tenemos nosotros tres, la directora de educación primaria y también nuestra office manager. ¿Cómo se dice, Edna?
Encargada de la oficina.
Sí, por supuesto, porque vamos a traducir esta junta virtual. Entonces, without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump into it. We are all here to talk about the start, our very excited start of TK through 2 back on campus next Monday. And I am going to share my screen and then go into presenting. And I will be saying this in English, and Edna's going to be following up in Spanish. And if I do my job correctly, you should be able to see my screen, and also I should be able to pin my video and her video. Welcome. We're so happy to have you here. We know there's a lot of questions, and we're hoping to answer them all for you today. Estamos muy emocionados para invitar sus hijos a campus otra vez de nuevo este lunes que viene. Y ahí estamos. Here we are on our brand new painted blacktop. The warriors, the superheroes of Sumac Elementary on campus. Your teacher team. This was us on Friday last for Halloween, dressed up like a bunch of M&Ms. And I thought it was a great opportunity to show you everybody in our hero stance. Señora Sandoval.
Estamos muy emocionados de darle la bienvenida de nuevo a nuestro campo escolar. Estas somos nosotras, listas para darles la bienvenida. Esta foto es del viernes pasado. Nos vestimos como M&M's, pero para que también tengan una idea de cómo se ve el patio escolar.
Yeah, and today we're going to be talking about our return to campus, our drop-off and pick-up procedures, student supports in place, what the campus looks like, what's it going to be like with maps, and hopefully just giving you a general overview of the whole day that makes you feel supported, loved, and safe, and ready to embark on our this continued journey together.
So de eso se trata esa reunión, de que ustedes sepan ahora el plan que tenemos. De cómo se ve nuestra escuela ahora que estamos listas para recibirlos y las medidas de seguridad que tenemos para que todos los estudiantes lo hagamos de una forma segura.
You might be used to getting to listen to Ms. Kintz talk about these things from her office over there in the district office. And so she's here to jump in and to offer clarity and any other bits of pieces that I may be forgetting. So thank you, Ms. Kintz, for keeping me on my toes today.
Thank you, Principal Logan. Do you want me to say a few words right now?
Yes, please.
Hey, great. Well, I just want to say that this is the moment that we've been waiting for here at the district office. Ever since I started in this new position, which was July 5th, we have been preparing and planning and talking with LA County to see how we can open schools. And it's actually happening now for next Monday. So we're just thrilled. I don't know if you want to translate for me, Mrs. Sandoval. Oh, I think you're muted, Mrs. Sandoval.
Yes, I just noticed that, sorry. So Ms. Kintz was sharing that since she, desde que ella empezó su puesto, ella está muy emocionada en julio porque fue cuando empezaron a tratar con el condado de Los Ángeles, el departamento de salud, cómo íbamos a reabrir nuestras escuelas. So ellos han estado trabajando todo este tiempo y finalmente lo ven una realidad. So ellos están muy emocionados en la parte del distrito porque finalmente lo están viendo una realidad.
So our district had to apply for special permission to open our schools, and they granted the LA County Office of Public Health they granted us permission to open. And they granted us permission to open because we have every single safety procedure in place. We have all the protective PPE, personal protective wear, and we have exposure management plans, and we are following the LA County Department of Public Health guidelines in that we have small cohorts of students. And Principal Logan will be talking about that soon.
Yes. Go ahead, Mrs. Sandoval.
Está compartiendo con nosotros que desde el principio ellos estaban con las pláticas del condado de Los Ángeles, y de la única forma que ellos nos pudieron dar el permiso de regresar es porque después que ellos visitaron las escuelas, ellos se dieron cuenta que nosotros tenemos los procedimientos de seguridad apropiados, tenemos todo el equipo de para protección personal. Tenemos también un plan para manejar los niveles de controles y seguir las guías que el Departamento de Salud y el Estado nos están pidiendo que todos tengamos.
Thank you. And I just have one more thing to say, and then I'll let Principal Logan continue. So the one thing I wanted to add is that our whole cabinet at the district office, the assistant superintendents, our superintendent, and all the directors, we are all adopting a school, and we're going to be at sites for both AM arrival and PM arrival. And I am lucky and blessed enough to get to be at Sumac all next week. So I'll be able to wave to you if you drive up and drop off your student.
Todos los directores y parte del gabinete del distrito estarán en las escuelas la semana que viene para darle la bienvenida a nuestros dos grupos de la mañana y en la tarde. Y si tiene suerte, ella les gustaría decirles, a saludarlos y conocerlos a sus estudiantes.
Thank you so much.
We have been working just as hard and in partnership and hand in hand with the district office for our site. Here you see in this picture, the beautiful front office, one of the hearts of the school of Sumac. And although it looks a little bit different with some plexiglass up, we are still going to be warm and gracious in greeting you just the same way we always would. You can see in the background of this picture, kind of to the side, our spacing dots. We are implementing some new procedures, and that's what I'd like to share with you now.
So esta foto es de la, como ven, es de la oficina. Se ve un poco diferente, pero estamos listos para darles la bienvenida con todas las medidas de precaución.
Oops, here we go. And so we know everybody is on waiting anxiously for their cohort placement. We will be releasing that tomorrow at 9 a.m. Just to remind you, although we have shared this in our communications over the past week, that we used a randomizer to sort the students into AM and PM, as well as looking at who had requested PM preferences. And that although we understand and appreciate the challenges that a half day school day presents to our families, we're not going to be able to change any placements at this time. That said, I am very happy to announce that the YMCA is coming back to Sumac campus. They will be operating in their same class or their same building and an additional classroom. And so more information about that should be sent via Parent Square. And of course, you can always go to the YMCA website for information on childcare.
Para regresar, mañana a las 9 de la mañana es cuando ustedes sabemos que están ansiosos por saber sus horarios. Mañana a las 9 de la mañana los daremos a conocer. Solamente para decirles y recordarles, como antes les habíamos dicho, que usamos la preferencia de las familias que optaron por el programa de la tarde. Y para el resto de las familias se usó un tipo lotería para dar el espacio disponible. Apreciamos mucho su, apreciamos mucho su conciencia, porque no vamos a poder hacer cambios. Esto ya está listo y lo daremos a conocer mañana. También estamos muy emocionados porque ya se dio el permiso para que YMCA esté en nuestras instalaciones, en nuestro campo, y podrán tener más información si visitan el sitio de internet de ellos.
We are also very excited to open up our campuses for all of our newest friends, our newest Voyagers in TK and Kinder, and for our Voyagers who are returning in first and second grade who haven't visited the campus in quite some time. So although you've been able to drive through and our materials pick up and picture day and things like that, you'll actually be able to walk onto campus and see everything firsthand. You'll be able to show your child their classroom location, kind of get the feel. We'll be present, Mrs. Sandoval, myself, Mrs. Chaidez, to take temperatures and to provide you maps, and then you can go and peek in and see what the campus looks like. We have these opportunities from Friday, 3:30 to 5, and Saturday from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. We will be conducting our health screenings, which is our temperature taking, at the main entrance, which is by our double doors of the flagpole, and also at Gate M. One of the new things that we've done this year is we've named our gates, and I'll show you that in just a moment. And so Gate M would have been called the Mariposa Gate. Mariposa M. There you go. Sandoval.
So, para las familias nuevas que no han tenido oportunidad este año de visitar nuestro campo escolar, pero también las familias que quisieran ver dónde está su salón de clases, los estamos invitando este viernes y sábado a que vengan con sus niños y se familiaricen con el campo escolar. Solamente recuerden que vamos a estar haciendo el chequeo de temperaturas antes de que entren a las locaciones. Por favor, usen su máscara y tengan la oportunidad de enseñarle a sus niños el campo escolar. Anything else? I think that's it.
We are going to have some new drop-off and pickup procedures, but what some things always stay the same, and that's going to be me asking you to please pull all the way forward to the end of the driveway, and we will have our adults out there in their blue safety vests ready to check your daily health screening, which we'll go over in just a moment, and also temperatures. But please remember, when you come into the main carpool lane, to pull all the way forward.
Una de las cosas que no va a cambiar este año va a ser que la directora Logan va a estar afuera diciéndoles, por favor, estaciónense hasta enfrente de la curva. No se estacionen solamente enfrente de la escuela. Va a haber dos o tres personas afuera con el chaleco de LVUSD, que es azul con unas rayas amarillas. Ellas van a estar checando que se haya hecho el cuestionario de salud en Parent Square antes de que se puedan bajar del carro.
You'll also notice lots of blue dots. I'll be talking about these blue dots. My phone still rings. What can I say? It's busy over here at the SUMAC office. But you'll see lots of blue dots. Those are our social distancing dots. And they're a great way to say, please find a dot. And remind ourselves visually to stay 6 feet apart from our friends.
Una de las cosas que van a usar, van a ver durante todo nuestro campo escolar son los puntos azules, que son puntos que se pintaron con que son 6 pies de distancia una de la otra. Eso nos ayuda a nosotros y también a los niños a mantener nuestra distanciamiento social.
This is the daily health screening form if you're looking at Parent Square from a desktop. This is from the Agora High School demo site, so this doesn't have any actual student information in it. Our colors are different. They're green and orange. So you might notice the colors don't look the same. But if you're operating Parent Square from a desktop site, when you go into your Parent Square, you will have your student or students visible in the upper left-hand corner, and you will click on health screening to submit the daily health screening. This is new. It's something we're asking of all families this year, and it has to be done before your child is able to exit the vehicle or walk onto campus.
Esta es una, la forma del cuestionario de salud. Cuando ustedes tienen acceso a Parent Square de una computadora de la casa, entonces Perdón, esta pantalla no es de la aplicación, esta es de una computadora. Entonces, van a ver que en la foto es de la escuela Agora High, la de nosotros es diferente, dice SUMAC, los colores son diferentes, verde y amarillo. Se pide que se llene este cuestionario de salud diariamente antes de salir de casa. Los niños no se pueden bajar del carro hasta que usted tenga esto.
El cuestionario, the form, will ask you two things. It's basically going to ask you in the past 14 days, has anyone in your household had close contact with someone who has or is suspected to have COVID-19? Hopefully you'll be able to respond no to that. And then it will ask you about some basic symptoms. Once you do that, it will ask you to input your name, your email, your phone number, and it will ask for your electronic signature. I'm gonna jump ahead before Mrs. Sandoval jumps in to show you what it looks like from my phone. Of course, this is today. I took this picture, so thank you to our PFA for hosting their PFA meeting this afternoon. And you can see at the bottom, it will have an orange form or an orange bar that says submit daily health screening. This is if you're doing it from your phone. I recommend downloading the Parent Square app if you haven't done already, because especially if you're using a smartphone, it'll autofill for you your telephone number, your email address, and then all you have to do is answer the questions and type in your name.
Esa es de la forma que se ve si estás usando la aplicación. Ella lo hizo de su propio teléfono esta mañana. La directora Logan recomienda que bajen la aplicación a sus teléfonos inteligentes. Es más fácil, ya que de esa manera se llena todo automáticamente. Las preguntas del cuestionario son, la primera es si usted en los 14 días anteriores, alguien en su casa ha tenido contacto cercano con alguien que ha estado o sospecha que tenga el virus COVID-19. Esperamos que pueda usted contestar no a esta pregunta, pero si es sí, entonces no se puede venir a la escuela ese día y tenemos que contactar a la oficina de la escuela con la señora Chaires.
Thank you very much. Go ahead and take a deep breath. That's a lot to spit out. We have Mr. Pinkney, one of our fantastic night custodians in the background behind Mrs. Sandoval, doing his daily cleaning as we speak. So it's nice to see from your end that that's happening even when we don't have students here, because the staff is here. We take the same measures to make sure everybody stays safe. Like Mrs. Sandoval said, and just to reiterate for our English speaking friends, that if you have had contact with anybody or you are experiencing in the last 48 hours any of those symptoms, we have to ask you to keep your child home, and Mrs. Chaires or the district nurse will reach out to you with more information. We are asking parents to do this every single morning, and so every morning we have faith that you'll be submitting these forms honestly, so we can make sure that everybody is happy and safe on campus. This is a map that I have updated. It should look pretty familiar for those of you who have been here before. For those of you who haven't, the drop-off and pickup loop that's located on the bottom with the arc is our carpool loop. And so the plus signs, the blue plus signs, are our entry or exit points on campus. And we're going to be having two different drop-off points on campus, but everybody will still use the carpool loop.
So este mapa es actualizado de la forma que lo vamos a estar usando para empezando el lunes. Tenemos dos puntos de entrada. Si se ven en el mapa, hay tres puntos azules que son como cruces, pero uno lo usaremos solamente para salida, los otros dos son solamente para entrada.
Right, and so Kinder and TK will use the M gate to enter. Van a entrar a través la puerta de la puerta M. They'll go through the Kinder patio socially distanced into their own classrooms, either Miss Rasmussen's class, or that says Peterson, it should say Mrs. Perez's class. I'm sorry, it must not be the most updated copy of the map. with Mrs. Perez's name. We did have to change Mrs. Perez's classroom over the past few weeks to make sure that she had a bathroom inside of her class. And because Mrs. Peterson is doing virtual, she was kind enough to move over to Mrs. Perez's class. So we made that switch. You'll also notice that grades 1 and 2 enter through the main double doors. If you can visualize the second set of double doors after the office, then they turn right down the hallway, which is our hallway with all of the beautiful bulletin boards. They go out toward the lunch area and then walk around to their classrooms. There, Mrs. Kroc, Mrs. Argano, Mrs. Gant, and Ms. Martinez will be waiting to greet them into their classroom.
So, por la entrada, si se fijan en los nombres de las entradas, es la entrada M, la puerta M. Por ahí van a entrar los niños del kinder. So el mapa que está en la pantalla no es el más actualizado, ya que tuvimos que cambiar a la maestra Porretz con Peterson, ya que la señora Peterson tenía baño en su salón de clases. Entonces, la señora Peterson trabaja de manera virtual. So no va a necesitar esa aula por este tiempo. Los niños de primero y segundo van a entrar por la puerta principal enfrente de aquí de la oficina. Van a entrar derecho hacia la biblioteca. Van a usar lo que es ese pasillo y van a salir de la forma yendo al área de almuerzos. Cuando vayan al patio, van a entrar por fuera de las salones de Miss Croc, de la señora Kroc, de la señora Argano, de señorita Martinez y señorita Gant.
We are very excited to have lots of adult support. There are more campus supervisors on campus now than we had previously, so all of the students will be kindly supported in their walk to their classrooms.
Estamos muy emocionados porque también tenemos bastante apoyo de supervisión del campo escolar que van a estar ayudando a los, no solamente a los niños, cuando estén caminando por los pasillos y afuera en el patio escolar.
I also wanted to just give you a little taste of what it feels like to come onto campus. Most of you have already seen the video that Dr. Stepanowski shared earlier this week, or actually Friday last. And so you will have to show proof of the daily health screening. We will have signs out front to remind you when you pull into campus. They'll look like this, ready, set, go. We're here to help. So if you forget, don't worry. We are going to ask you to pull into one of the visitor spots and you can complete the health screening and then we will escort your child across the parking lot and into campus.
So, una de las maneras de que vamos a usar esto, como entendemos, es algo nuevo para todos y si se les olvidó hacerlo antes de salir de casa, no importa. Solamente les vamos a pedir amablemente que se estacionen en uno de nuestros espacios para visitantes para que hagan el cuestionario de salud en Parent Square. Una vez que ya lo hagan, uno de las supervisores del campo escolar van a ayudarle a su hijo a tomar la temperatura antes de que salga del carro y lo van a caminar hacia la fila que le toque entrar.
Like I said, we will all be using the main carpool loop, but to maximize social distancing and efficiency, our kinder students will be moving directly. TK and kinder will move directly to the M gate, which is located on the far side of the carpool loop, and enter through the kinder patio doors. And first and second will go through the double doors. Just remember, we're going to pull all the way forward. I've gotten a lot of questions about, can I walk my child up to school? The answer to that question is yes. If you're riding a bike with your child, scootering, or walking your child to school, that's fine. We'll wave goodbye or give a hug at the flagpole, and that's when our campus supervisors will check again your phone for the daily health screening and take your child's temperature to make sure that they can walk into campus.
So tenemos, para reiterar nuevamente, las entradas van a ser los niños de TK y Kinder van a entrar por la puerta M, que está al final de la curva. Los niños de primero y segundo van a entrar por las puertas doble de la, junto a la oficina. Hemos tenido algunas preguntas de que si los padres pueden caminar a los estudiantes a la escuela, si pueden traer su bicicleta o su scooter también, su patineta. Lo pueden traerlos, pero no van a poder entrar al edificio. Simplemente donde está la bandera, ahí pueden darle su abrazo, pueden decirle tenga buen día y ahí se despiden.
Remember that when you're on a campus, any Las Virgenes campus, and specifically Sumac, we're going to ask that you always wear a face covering. The covering must cover your nose and mouth, just like this, and it can only be removed for eating or for physical activity. Students are going to be using those blue spatial dots that are 6 feet distance and our red dots in the hallway. Their parents must stay in their cars. That's why we encourage you to come on Friday and Saturday or say goodbye at the flagpole. And remember that our office will be closed during this 15 minutes of arrival for both cohorts and also dismissal for both cohorts. So that way we can have all of our adults supporting supervision of our students.
Un recordatorio que los estudiantes tienen que usar la máscara que les va a cubrir su boca. Tiene que cubrir la boca, pero también la nariz. Tiene que estar de aquí a aquí. Solamente puede ser removida para comer o la actividad física. Los estudiantes van a estar usando los I went blank. Los espacios azules que van a estar, que ya están pintados en nuestro patio escolar, que es con 6 pies de distancia. Los padres tienen que quedarse en sus carros, no pueden bajarse del carro, y si van a caminar, despídanse de sus niños para donde está la bandera. Un recordatorio también es que la oficina va a estar cerrada durante la entrada y la salida de cada grupo. Esto para asegurarnos de que todo el personal esté apoyando a las que se tomen las medidas de seguridad y darle la bienvenida a sus hijos.
This slide speaks for itself. I'm not going to read it all for you, but remember, we wear masks at school. We wear them before school when we show up, while we're on campus, while we're getting to our car, and if anybody needs a mask, don't worry, we have lots of extras.
No vamos a leer todo esto, pero solamente decirles, nosotros usamos las máscaras, el personal, todo el tiempo en la escuela. Si ustedes necesitan una máscara, los niños algo les pasa, no se preocupen, nosotros les podemos proveer. Tenemos bastantes máscaras disponibles.
We talked about temperature taking. It's going to happen in the car. The students will be walked and being greeted by teachers. And just to remember, we have short windows of time between drop-off and school starting. We have 15 minutes, 8 to 8:15 for our morning cohort or cohort A, and 12:10 to 12:25 for cohort B.
Hemos estado hablando de que tenemos el procedimiento de checar las temperaturas cuando están los niños en el carro. So, esos son los horarios que tenemos y el tiempo entre el grupo A y el grupo B, que sería de 10:40 a 12:10.
This morning I sent our one-page safety sheet and included on that are all of these pieces about what it looks like or if you come late. And Mrs. Sandoval was gracious enough to translate that into Spanish, so I'll be following up by emailing out the recording of this with the Spanish version of our one-page safety sheet as well.
En la mañana, la señora Logan compartió con ustedes los procedimientos que tendremos solamente en una hoja de papel. Se acaba de traducir y más tarde la directora Logan lo va a mandar en español también en adición con esta presentación.
So we're asking that when students are on campus wearing a mask, staying in the right direction, following our directional signs, and wave high instead of stopping to speak in the hallway. Just going to jump back for a second to our map to show you that we have changed the flow of some of our hallways. It's going to be a great opportunity for you to see on Friday and Saturday. There's lots of yellow arrows. That's why they're yellow on the map, because they're yellow in our hallways as well. And they will help you remember where the new flow of traffic is, foot traffic. So instead of speaking in the hallway, we'll use our quiet voices to say hi and wave to our friends and to continue on to an outside location before engaging in conversation in a safe, socially distant way.
So, un recordatorio es que vamos a estar usando máscaras, vamos a estarnos en la dirección correcta en los pasillos y solamente vamos a poder saludarnos cuando nos encontremos en el pasillo. No vamos a parar, no vamos a hablar a ese tiempo. En el mapa ella estaba mostrando cómo fluye ahora el tráfico cuando nosotros vayamos a visitar las aulas. Esa es una oportunidad que si ustedes quieren venir el viernes o el sábado, una oportunidad para que ustedes vean el flujo que tenemos ahora.
Just remember, we're approaching this as an entire community. We're in this together. We've been in it since the start, and we're here to support one another. So please don't forget to take your child's temperature and to complete the health screening before arriving. If your child is not feeling well, you're going to have to keep them at home. And don't fret, because if something happens and your child becomes ill at school, we'll be here in the care room, which I'm going to show you momentarily, to take care of them. Unfortunately, we will need you to come right back around to pick them up.
Una de las cosas es que queremos reiterarles, estamos haciendo esto juntos, estamos haciendo esto como comunidad. Por favor, hagan su parte de tomar la temperatura de sus niños en la mañana, completen el cuestionario de salud en Parent Square antes de llegar a la escuela. Si su niño no se siente bien, por favor, manténganlo en la casa. Si su niño se enferma aquí o cuando está dentro de la escuela, ahorita les va a enseñar la directora Logan el plan que tenemos, y estamos preguntando que si por favor les llamamos, vengan lo antes posible a recogerlos si es que se necesita.
These are some of our classrooms, your very own classrooms. It's your first sneak peek at what the classrooms are going to look like. We have Mrs. Crocs, let's see, Mrs. Arganos and Mrs. Poretz ready for you here to see that we have desks spaced out. You can see that every child has their own space. Teachers are still diligently working on these to present a wonderful and warm final product for you all on Monday.
Como primicia, ustedes serán los primeros en ver los salones de clases. Está el salón de la maestra, señora Croc, de la señora Argano y señora Perez. Ellas todavía están trabajando, los salones no están casi, pero están casi completos.
In these pictures, you will see, you can't see them in front, so I wanted to show you outside that we have dots for students to wait on while the teacher is greeting other students into their classroom. Those will be the blue dots that we have around campus.
Esa es una muestra de los círculos que tenemos pintados, solamente que son azules, para cuando estén los niños esperando fuera del salón para que la maestra los deje entrar al aula.
We also have hand sanitizer at the ready at both entrances and exit points of each classroom, and the teacher will be giving each kiddo a squirt of hand sanitizer. The picture on the left-hand side is of our front double doors, and you can barely see it if you squint really hard and look in, but there is a touchless hand sanitizer there as well, because every time we come in or out of a classroom or in or out of the building, we sanitize our hands.
Esa es una muestra en el lado derecho de que el gel alcohol antibacterial está en los salones de clases. Los niños antes de entrar al salón o después de salir se van a hacer en sus manitas. también, si se fijan, en la entrada principal hay unos que son dispensadores también de alcohol en gel, pero son sin tocar, son automáticos.
It's a lot of new procedures to get our head around, and that's why the teachers are on campus diligently this week with reduced instructional minutes. And I want you to take a deep breath and know, not to worry, that we'll teach all of your students what the procedures are when we greet them on campus on Monday. But please take an opportunity to watch the video sent out by Dr. Stepanowski with your child before then to get them ready for what a school day will look like.
Sabemos que es muchas cosas nuevas, sabemos y entendemos que es mucha información, pero solamente les queremos reiterar que las maestras han estado tomando este tiempo, como supieron esta semana su horario cambió un poco, pero es por esta razón, porque las maestras están preparando el salón de clases para darles la bienvenida. Si pueden, por favor, vean el video que mandó nuestro superintendente con sus hijos y así ellos van a tener una idea también de cómo pueda ser su día.
Remember that your child can bring a snack. There will be recess, but please keep the snacks small because, as we're going to talk about in a little bit, there's going to be grab-and-go meals every day for each child. And also, they only have 15 minutes, so it's a small little bite before they go home.
Va a haber un recreo en a la hora que los niños estén en la escuela. So, si gustan mandar un pequeño snack, está bien. No manden uno grandote, ahorita les vamos a decir por qué. También solamente tenemos 15 minutos de recreo y esto lo van a usar para que los niños jueguen un movimiento.
We do have our hydration stations open to refill water bottles, but our actual drinking fountains are closed. So make sure to send a water bottle. If you forget, the teachers will have plastic cups in their classroom that they can deliver to students. But reusable water bottles are always a great first stop.
Recuerden que nuestras estaciones para rellenar las botellas de agua están abiertas. Lo que está cerrado y no podemos usar es la fuente de agua. Entonces, los niños van a poder rellenar su botella de agua, pero les pedimos que ya la tengan llena y que usen una botella reusable de la casa. En caso de que ellos no traigan, nosotros tenemos vasitos desechables de que ellos pueden usar.
We are also working diligently this week to create individual student supply packs that will have all of the basic and necessary supplies that they need to be successful while they're on campus. No need to bring those things. The teachers will be communicating with you directly what they would like to be brought onto campus. But our intention is to limit any materials going back and forth, knowing that your child will have their very own pencil case and their very own space of their very own supplies.
En algo que hemos trabajado también esta semana es en poder proporcionarles una cajita con útiles escolares. Así no tienen necesidad los niños de llevar y de traer cosas a la casa. Es la intención, limitar la cantidad de materiales que van y vienen a la casa o de la escuela. Cada niño tendrá su cajita individual y su caja donde va a poner sus cosas solamente. Pero más información va a venir de su maestra.
We want students to be safe in every location of the school building, and this includes the bathroom. So our some rules don't change. Go, flush, wash, leave. That's the same procedures that we've had in place at Sumac forever. The difference is now the bathroom is socially distanced. So we allow one child to use it at a time. We have campus supervisors stationed outside to help students remember that they need to wait their turn. We have dots in front of the bathroom, and we will encourage the 20-second hand wash while they're in there. People can sing the ABC song, which is a great way to remember, or of course, an old favorite, Happy Birthday. Either way, students will have access to the bathrooms and bathroom use will be monitored from the outside of an adult, just making sure it's one child at a time and that they are washing their hands.
Una de las cosas que no va a cambiar es cómo usamos el baño. Vamos, le bajamos, nos lavamos las manos, nos salimos. La único que sí va a cambiar es que solamente va a estar una persona por baño. Vamos a tener afuera supervisores que van a estar por fuera del baño, asegurándonos que solamente un niño entra a usar el baño a la vez. Ya que se salgan, entonces van a poder entrar el otro niño y asegurarse que ellos estén lavando las manitas por 20 segundos. Pueden usar la canción del abecedario o la de Happy Birthday, la que les guste.
Our school counselor will be returning onto site. She will be doing all of her visits via Zoom. She will not be going into the classroom, but I did want to take this opportunity to remind you of the counseling services that are available and the wonderful webpage that Ms. Valdi has created if you are in need of counseling services.
La señora Valdi es nuestra consejera escolar. Va a venir a regresar al campo escolar. Va a continuar ella también con sus juntas, con sus grupos por medio de Zoom. Y esa es una oportunidad muy buena para que ustedes visiten su sitio de internet que ella tiene. Y si necesitan cualquier ayuda, le pueden mandar mensaje por ahí.
Also, library procedures will not change. The library will maintain socially distanced. It will be available on the web, and books will be available for students to pick up by putting them on hold, and they will be waiting for them at the classroom or delivered to the classroom to be put into their book bags.
De la forma que la biblioteca va a funcionar, va a ser igual al como ha estado ahorita. Ustedes pueden preguntar o pueden checar los libros por internet, y la señora Stratton va a entregar los libros al salón de clases de sus hijos.
Remembering that for our virtual academy students and our 3-5 students, those books will be placed on hold and placed on the library cart out front by the flagpole for your pickup on Tuesdays.
Es un recordatorio que para nuestros amiguitos que están en clases virtuales o nuestros alumnos que están en 3, 4 y 5 también, ellos también pueden utilizar este método para checar los libros. Y está de la forma, es enfrente de la oficina, es un carrito donde puedes dejar los libros, entregas y dejas los otros.
STEAM time will still be honored. It will be available for students in the opposite of their cohort on campus. And we are working on that schedule as we speak.
Las clases de STEAM van a seguir fuera del tiempo que los niños no estén en el campo escolar. También los videos van a estar disponibles para las familias después del día escolar. Estamos trabajando en un nuevo horario. Y lo tendremos pronto.
Now we've gotten through the school day. We've talked about all of the procedures that you're going to see on campus. And it's time for our kiddos to go home until we see them again tomorrow. Remember, please show up as close to your time for dismissal as possible. Both TK and kindergarten, first and second grade, will all be picked up at the front of the school. And they'll be waiting for you on a socially distanced blue dot.
Bueno, ya hablamos de todo el día desde que llegaron, todo el día. Ahora es la hora de salir. Los estudiantes van a ser recogidos en frente de la escuela en la curva. Van a estar esperándolos en un círculo azul, totalmente respetando el distanciamiento social. Por favor, lleguen a tiempo.
Remember that our flow of traffic on foot has changed. So our students from kindergarten will be coming out. Oh, and here's updated with Porets on this page. They will be coming out from the double doors. So they enter in through the patio. They'll come out through the double doors to a blue dot. And our students in first and second grade will get a nice little walk through the lunch area in the blacktop, out the S gate and around the multipurpose room over to the blue dots of the carpool lane. We will have campus supervisors out. We'll do that for cohort A, and then we'll do it all over again once the campus gets cleaned for cohort B.
So, si se pueden dar cuenta en este mapa actualizado, va a ser los puntos de salida. Los nuestros amiguitos del kinder y TK van a salir por lo que es casi que enfrente de la oficina, por la entrada de las puertas dobles. y van a estar ahí listos para ser recogidos en los círculos azules en la curva. Nuestros amigos del primero y segundo grado, ellos van a dar un poquito de, van a caminar en lo que es todo el patio, enseguida que está el, la puerta S, que está junto al NPR. Ahí también hay un mar de círculos azules con distanciamiento social y ahí, nos van, ahí los van a estar esperando, los del grupo A y los del grupo B.
We will have meal pickup available for all of our students as they are dismissed. They will get... That is Mrs. Kelly Beater wanting to talk to me. She's gonna have to wait. They'll look like this. It's a white bag. They come with both breakfast and lunch. This may be for my child's meal today. And we are going to have them as grab them as they go out on their way to the main carpool loop.
So esas, esas bolsas blancas son los almuerzos y desayunos que tendremos listos para los estudiantes a la hora de salida. Ya vienen así listas en esas bolsas blancas y traen desayuno y almuerzo.
I wanted to talk a little bit about the health office. We now have two health office locations. Of course, our typical health office will still be used for all of non-illness medical needs. Our lost teeth that happen on campus, especially with our second graders, administering daily medication and any kind of abrasion or injury.
Les queremos hablar un poquito acerca de la oficina de auxiliar de la enfermería. Va a estar abierta para el uso de, para administrar medicina diaria, para tratar cualquier raspadura o cualquier cosa que pase en el patio escolar. También esos dientes que les encanta a los niños de segundo perderlos.
What's new is that we have an isolation health office, which we'll lovingly call the care room to our students when they're on campus. And this room, which was the old steam room across from the main office, has been converted. And it is the room designated for any child who is experiencing symptoms related to an illness. And it's a beautiful new room that hopefully nobody has to visit.
Le hemos llamado a nuestro, al salón que era de la señora Malet, le hemos puesto ahora, va a ser nuestro care room. Ahí es donde vamos a llevar a los niños que presenten cualquier síntoma. Ojalá y ninguno lo tenga que visitar, pero les vamos a enseñar dónde vamos a poner a estos niños que es cuando ellos necesiten estar de forma de isolación.
What I want you to know is that we are working diligently and at this point around the clock to make sure that you feel comfortable having your students with us on campus. In between cohorts, we have a whole crew that comes through to clean all of the classroom, all of the supplies and the restrooms. And of course, it happens again at the end of the day.
Queremos asegurarles que nosotros estamos trabajando casi que todo el tiempo para asegurarnos que no, todo esté listo para recibirlos. Nuestros equipo de mantenimiento y limpieza va a estar limpiando entre medio de, los, de la llegada y la salida del grupo nuevo y al final del día también. Siempre nuestro equipo de mantenimiento trabaja inmensamente para asegurarnos que esté todo limpio y sanitizado de la forma correcta.
Just to recap, although we can't host visitors on campus, we have spent months preparing to welcome your students onto campus, and we are so excited. The first day of school is always my favorite day of the school year, and I got to do it via Zoom a little bit earlier, and now I get to do it again with your kiddos, TK through two, and we're here to help. If you need additional help, please don't hesitate to reach out so we can navigate through this part of our journey together.
So, de manera final, queremos reiterarles, desafortunadamente no podemos tener visitantes por ahora que visiten nuestro campo escolar, pero hemos pasado meses preparándonos, como dijo la señora Kent. Hemos tenido pasado meses preparándonos para este momento y estamos muy emocionados de saber que próximamente le daremos la segunda bienvenida, esta vez físicamente, a nuestros niños de TK a segundo grado.
We will see you Monday, Voyagers. And although I won't be in my Voyager suit like there in my avatar, I will be wearing my mask. Greeting you all for both morning cohort and afternoon cohort. Thank you very much for your attention. And I'll be following up this presentation with the one pagers as promised.
Este lunes les daremos la bienvenida de nuevo. Aunque la señora Logan no va a estar con su traje de Voyager, pero sí vamos a tener nuestras máscaras listos para darles la bienvenida.
Thank you so much to Director Kintz for being here to support us on this webinar. Thank you so much to Mrs. Sandoval for your translations.
Gracias, señora Kintz, por estar con nosotros.
And thank you, Principal Logan. Thank you, Mrs. Sandoval.
Have a great day, Voyagers.